Good morning, Davao, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihecatso. And for the headlines, weather forecast, Easter list affecting Mindanao. Local news, WTE, plant solution to landfills crisis, say. DCWD apologizes for water interruption. Baste stands up for accountability. Mabel Sunga Acosta plans legal action amid confusion over Minda leadership change. National news, Supreme Court uphold disbarment of Gadon. UP President unveils 8 million mucil glycogen production plant in Tacloban. International news, British climber and Nepali guide feared dead after climbing Everest. Inside a dangerous rescue for Brazil floods victims. Entertainment news. Veterinary surgeon lifts MasterChef trophy. Bulacan's candidate crowned Miss Universe Philippines 2024. And for the sports news, UAAP best libero Menard Guerrero gets a spike of humor from supportive friends. Paquita accused of beating Marquette yellow cards. Featured stories, the Mediterranean Isle where hikers stay for free. Marina Summers dedicates MUPH opening number to LGBT community. For the side stories and for the trivia, do you know that Davao City prides itself on its strong agricultural industry? Weather forecast. Mindanao will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms due to easterlist. Light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news. Davao City Councilor Louis Jan J. Bunguyan advocated for the waste to energy WTE plant as the solution to Davao City's landfills issue. During the Aprobado sa Consejo session on Tuesday morning, May 21, 2024, the Sangguniang Panglungsod Bunguyan said, Bunguyan emphasized that despite the waste burning involved, the WTE plant would operate under strict regulation. In 2015, the WTE project required approximately 500 to 550 tons of garbage, a quantity not met by the city waste production at that time. However, this year, Davao City waste output has increased to about 700 to 800 tons. Bunguyan explained that the WTE project would involve burning garbage to generate energy. He reassured that environmental concern would be addressed during parallels with Japan's real-time monitoring of carbon dioxide emission, where exceeding limits triggers automatic plants shutdown. Davaoenos were caught off guard by an unexpected water interruption from the Davao City Water District, DCWD, on Wednesday morning, May 22, 2023. DCWD explained in a statement that the emergency interruption starting at 12:01 that day in areas served by the Dumoy Water Supply System, WSS, groundwater source, was due to a damaged recloser switch. In a subsequent update, the office announced that DLPC had successfully repaired the damaged recloser switch, with most affected areas expected to have their connection restored by 1 p.m. Alan Albior, a Matina resident, shared with Sunstar Davao via text message the heavy impact of the recent water interruption. He described the challenge of commuting to work without access to water for bathing and cooking due to a lack of stored water. Davao City Mayor Sebastian Baste Duterte expressed his respect for those who defend the poor, the weak, and the powerless. The youngest son of a former President Rodrigo Duterte has openly voiced his discontent with President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.'s administration. The mayor criticized the administration for prioritizing politics over the people's well-being and accused them of aligning with adversaries of the previous administration, citing the revival of peace talk with insurgents as an example. Maria Belen Mabel Acosta remains skeptical as she officially steps down as the chairperson of the Mindanao Development Authority, MINDA. 2 years after being appointed as the eighth leader of the government agency by former President Rodrigo Rua Duterte, the second Mindanaoan female chair expressed confusion as she gracefully exited during the general staff meeting on Wednesday afternoon, May 22, 2024. Acosta has experienced sleepless night and considerable stress due to the uncomfortable situation. The embarrassment and humiliation are unbearable for her. She is puzzled by the decision of two schedules, another appointment for her current position, and continually questioned what she might have done wrong to deserve such disrespect, as she can't recall any wrongdoing. National news. The Supreme Court SC has found disbarred lawyer Larry Gadon guilty of gross misconduct for committing perjury and making accusation based on hearsay. In a statement, the Supreme Court said the ruling was based on the complaint filed before the Integrated Bar of the Philippines, IBP. The complaint has sought Gadon's disbarment for falsehoods in an impeachment complaint he had filed against the Chief Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno. Sereno before the House of the Representative, as well as the filing of baseless criminal cases against several Supreme Court officials. University of the Philippines, UP, President Angelo Jimenez led the groundbreaking ceremony of the 8 million Musel glycogen production facility at the UP Tacloban campus in Barangay Santa Elena, Tacloban City on Thursday, May 23, 2024. The plant, which will be the first in the Philippines, will develop methods for producing glycogen on a scale that can be commercialized and used by large industries, said Jimenez, who was in the city as guest speaker for the 51st anniversary of the UP Tacloban College, UPTC. The Musel glycogen production plant is mainly financed by the Department of Science and Technology, Philippines Council for Agriculture, Aquatic and Natural Resources Research and Development, DOST, PCAA-RRD, the government-run news agency reported. During his visit, Jimenez also represented UP's strategic plan for 2023 to 2029 and the plan for the elevation of UP Tacloban from a college to a constituent university of the UP system to better serve the needs of the people of Eastern Visayas. International news. A British climber and his Nepali guide are feared dead after being hit by fallen ice as they descended from Everest summit. Daniel Peterson, 39, from Wakefield, and guide Pastinji Sherpa, 23, reached the top of the 29,032 feet, 8,849 meter peak on Tuesday as part of a group. They have not been heard from since adventure company 8K expedition side rescuers were unable to find the pair of and the chances of finding them alive was not possible. The company which organized the expedition said the collapse happened on Hillary Steps, a vertical rock face near the summit, and that the man fell down towards the Tibet side through a very vertical step. I came here with just the cloth on my back. Nothing at all, say 71 years old Albertina Simonite. She is one of about 6,000 people now living in the University Sports Hall in Brazil, southernmost state, Rio Grande do Sul. It has been converted into a shelter for those whose homes have been destroyed in the worst floods in the state history, which have killed more than 150 people, displaced more than 600,000, and left whole cities underwater. People are sleeping on mattresses on the cold and crowded floor. Albertina says she saw 50 helicopters flying over the roof of her house before a boat finally rescued her family. She is with her husband, 4 of her sons, and 2 of her grandchildren in the shelter. Entertainment news. A veterinary surgeon whose love of cooking is inspired by his Sri Lankan heritage has been crowned the 20th winner of BBC TV's MasterChef. Brian Piratapan, 29, from Chingford's, impressed Judge John Toredo and Greg Wallace to beat 57 others in this year's amateur contest. Mr. Piratapan cooked a winning menu of a seafood starter, a spice, venison, main, and a dessert of white chocolate and cardamom and chaperon cremeaux with a lime and chili sorbet. The show is one of the reasons I'm the cook I am today, he said. He was working as a veterinary surgeon in Bristol before entering the show and said he had watched the show since he was a boy. The food I grew up with is never boring. Coming from a Tamil Sri Lankan background, we had nice food on the table and it's never bland, he said. Chelsea Manalo of Bulacan bested 52 other beauty queen as she was crowned Miss Universe Philippines 2024 during the coronation night held at the Mall of Asia Arena Wednesday night, May 22, 2024. Manalo 25 succeeded Miss Universe Philippines 2023 Michelle D. She will then represent the Philippines at the Miss Universe 2024 pageant, which is set to be held in Mexico. Named runner-up Wednesday night were Stacy Gabriel of Cainta, first runner-up Maria Atesa Manalo of Quezon Province, second runner-up Tara Valencia of Baguio, third runner-up, and Christy Lynn McGarry of Taguig, fourth runner-up. For the sports news, UAAP Season 86 best libero Menard Guerrero, aka Nadine, shares his thankfulness to the DLSU Green Spikers after their valiant effort in the recently concluded collegiate men's volleyball scene. "There aren't enough words to express how grateful I am. All I know is that I have so much love in my heart and trust in my heart ahead for the team," Nadine wrote. "But as they say, true friends don't just have your back, they roast you too." West Ham midfielder Lucas Paqueta has been charged by the Football Association for allegedly getting booked deliberately for the improper purpose of affecting the betting market. The four charges related to the Premier League games against Leicester City on 12 November in 2022, plus 2023 fixtures against Aston Villa on 12 of March, Leeds United on the 21st May, and Bournemouth on August 12. The 26-year-old Brazil international had been ordered investigations since last summer over suspicious betting patterns. An FA statement said, "It's alleged that the Paquita directly sought to influence the progress, conduct, or any other respect of or occurrence in these matches by intentionally seeking to receive a card from the referee for the improper purpose of affecting the betting market in order for one or more persons to profit from betting." Featured stories: an inciting new program is seeking to transform a rugged corner of the Italian island into an outdoor lover's paradise. Renowned for its pristine beaches and dramatic granite cliffs, the Italian island of Sardinia has long been known as a jet settlers or setters paradise. But away from the mega yacht and the glitterati of its glamorous Costa Smeralda resort, much of the Mediterranean second's largest island remained as rugged and spoiled wilderness waiting to be explored. Now, a group of hikers and former miners are hoping to lure adventure seekers to Sardinia's seldom visited southwest coast by offering a free logging along the island stunning 500-kilometer Santa Barbara mining route. Filipina drag queen Marina Summers dedicated her opening number in the Miss Universe Philippines 2024 Coronation Night to LGBT community. Marina performed her song, "Ama Filipina," a new spin on Maymay in Tratas Amaka Bugari or Amaka Bugera for the contestant introduction. The audience cheered when Marina introduced herself and shouted the Philippines as if she was also a contestant of the legend of the local pageant. This is for every Baklang Chikiting that dreamed of saying this iconic line, "Oras na para tayo naman ang rumampa," she said in the caption. For the side stories, let's watch this. And for the trivia, do you know that Davao City prides itself on its strong agricultural industries? The city's fertile land and favorable climate make it prime location for cultivating various crops, including bananas, coconuts, and cacaos. And that's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the Pinoy Rub YouTube channel's updates. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihecacho. Good morning.